A military aircraft in distress. A four-person crew on board suddenly facing engine failure. It all made for some tense moments at Milwaukee's 128th Air Refueling Wing.
And WISN 12 News' Kent Wayne Scott is at the 128th. Kent, you were there to witness the emergency landing.
Yeah, and this is the plane, in fact, right behind me here now, as you can see, safely back on the ground. But earlier today, all eyes were on its emergency landing. It touched down behind me in the distance at the far end of the airfield from where I'm standing, surrounded by emergency vehicles and with a crew both on board and on the ground prepared for whatever might happen. Sheriff squads raced toward the airfield. On opposite ends of the runway, fire and emergency vehicles with lights flashing and crews standing by ready to react. In the air, circling overhead, a Wisconsin Air National Guard KC-135R refueling tanker suddenly in trouble.
The call came in around the 12 o'clock hour, what it was commonly referred to as an IFE, an in-flight emergency. We had reports of trouble with one of the engines.
The 50-year-old Stratotanker had been on a local refueling mission when the engine failed. It circled the airport to burn off excess fuel and then made its approach. The aircraft still had three working engines and an experienced four-person crew, and as it touched down and was swarmed by emergency vehicles, it's that crew that was on the minds of their colleagues standing by.
It's not just a pilot, it's not just a co-pilot or a boom operator, it's our brother, it's our sister. So there's concern, you know, just for your comrade in arms. And it was a relief to see it land safely, but there really wasn't a doubt that it wouldn't.
As you can see, the search for the cause of the engine failure began almost immediately. In fact, maintenance crews were on the scene within minutes of the aircraft touching down.
And as the plane was examined, the crew headed into a debriefing session to determine what went wrong with the engine, and more importantly, what went right to bring the aircraft down safely.
There's always concern, but we know we're well trained. We know we're ready for something like this. So just like any challenge, you know you're ready for it.
Now, that engine cover that we showed you was off and open before is now back on, but maintenance crews continue to search for what caused that engine to fail. The emergency landing went off without incident, but before this plane can go back into the air and on another refueling mission, they'll have to determine exactly what caused it, of course, and repair it. How long that takes is unclear at this point. Reporting live from the 128th Air Refueling Wing, I'm Ken Wayne Scott, WISN 12 News.
Thank you.